Good morning to everyone. I welcome you for IABS IAS Academy Current Affairs Channel IABS IAS News Bureau. And today we are going to discuss about the Hindu news article dated on 16th of August, which talks about National Digital Health India Mission, which was launched by our Honorable Prime Minister on the event of Independence Day celebration. The next one is related to Government decision on reviewing the age of marriage under some particular committee report. And third one is Suomoto case, which has been taken by Supreme Court for the tweet which is being tweeted by Prashant Bhushan. And last one is related to science and technology report on paralysis with respect to newborn babies. And let me move on to the first article. The first article, as I said, yesterday Government of India has launched a key mission called National Digital Health Mission. This National Health Mission has been launched by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji on Independence Day celebration occasion. Here the key point that we need to keep in mind when we need to looking in terms of UPSC preparation is what is the vision of this particular program, why government created this mission. This is to create the support universal health coverage in an efficient, accessible, inclusive, affordable, timely and safe manner through a provision of wide range of data, information and infrastructural services, duly leveraging the open and interoperable standard-based digital system and ensuring the security, confidentiality and privacy of health-related personal information. This is the vision which is given by Ministry of Health Affairs with respect to this particular program. The key points are NDHM, that is National Digital Health Mission, is a complete digital health ecosystem with personal health IDs for every Indian and digitalization of health record as well as the registry of doctors and health facility across the country. And the second key point is this digital platform will be launched with four features. First one is health ID for every citizen and personal health record of every citizen. Digi doctor, which is the doctor can be consulted from any citizen from any place through digital platform. And the fourth one is digital facility register, and this ID is applicable across all state, all hospital, all diagnostic laboratories and pharmacies. At the later stage, they are going to include e-pharmacy and telemedicine services and regulatory guidelines for which it is being framed. And the platform is voluntary and it will be up to individual to be yet enrolled on this particular app. This is not a system which is going to be mandatory for all the citizens. And this health record will be shared only after authorization by the individual, where the privacy of the data has been properly been taken care. And through DigiDoctor option, the citizen can able to allow the doctor from across the country to enroll their details, including their contact number, if they want to provide them, they will be available in this particular platform. The doctor will also be assigned a digital signature for which, for free of cost, which can be used for writing prescriptions. And the government, however, feels the utility of the app will ensure widespread participation by the citizen. National Health Association, NHA, the implementing agency of Ayushman Bharat, has created this platform which will be available in the form of app as well as in the website. And this program is having a budget of 470 crores for the proposal, but final NHA proposal may not seek more than 400 crores. These are all the important key points that we need to add. Here they had two different articles with respect to this program. As I said, NDHM will provide a support to all the citizen in terms of finding right doctor, seeking appointment, paying consultation fee, and making several round of hospital related procedure for prescribed sheet that has been developed by Health Ministry. And apart from that, the core idea is, the core building blocks of NHDM is to create Health ID, DigiDoctor, Health Facility Register that shall be owned, operated and maintained by Government of India alone. Here the private stakeholder will have an equal opportunity to integrate with these building blocks and create their own product. However, core activities, verification, for example, generation of health ID or approval of doctor and doctor or health facility shall remain with government alone. This is the about NDHR, that is National Digital Health Mission. And second article is related to reviewing the age of marriage. Why this particular article is coming here? In the recent report which has been given by our health ministry, they have formed a committee to ensure daughters, that is women, no longer suffer from malnutrition and they are all married off at the right age. To ensure this thing, they have made a committee. That committee is headed by Jaya Jigli, and that comprise secretaries from health of Ministries of Health Resource Development, Human Resource Development, Women Development, Child Development and Health and Family Welfare. This committee needs to provide a report on July 31st that was not able to done due to this COVID situation. And now they are giving the recommendation. It will be soon tabled in Parliament. Here the major thing is why the important direction is being taken in the sense is to welcome a recognition at the highest level in government about the linkage between health of the mother and babies when girl is married too early and as the child before at the age of 20 years. This is related to giving birth before attaining 20 years. Why it is now need to be discussed? The challenges are not directly related to reasons related to early marriage. It is related to much more even. Why it has been now talked? When we look at article which is published in Lancet, Child and Adolescent Health Issue publication, they are quoting that mothers between the age of 10 and 19, which is not a constitutional age to get married, but in India, the persons who are between the age of 10 and 19 are giving birth. 5% of their kids are sudden. That means their brain growth is too low. And between the age of 20 to 24, the sudden rate is around 11%. Here, the major thing is, if the child is giving birth by an adolescent mother, 10% of the points are prevalent to the low weight as the result of adolescent mother. To overcome this problem, they had given recommendation which includes increasing the age of first marriage and age at the first birth. Girl educations are promising approach to improve the maternal and child nutrition. And other underlining factors are, we had a law called Prohibition of Child Marriage Act 2006. Instead of that, we need to curb child marriage. But that is the only weapon that needs to be played by the hands of parents to punish the daughters for elopements, and is used to conjunction with other laws to punish boys in self-arranged marriages also. Apart from that, there should be a measures or a preventive system or an education to be provided to educate the need of awareness about safe sex and access to reproductive health information, and improvising access to education and retaining the girls in education system so that they are able to transition from elementary to secondary education, and beyond which they can't delay marriage. these are all the things that has been highly quoted in this article. And finally, it ends with, if we are simultaneously working with girls in school and invest in economic and social empowerment of women and girls, as well as targeted social and behavior changes communication campaign to put an end to the harmful practice. Soon we are looking, wait for a notification which might be come from central government, which might increase the age group, legal age for getting married. And this third article, we have already discussed about this article yesterday. Suomoto contempt, power is an inherent power, which has been once again envisaged by Supreme Court. And there is no need to get prior consent from Attorney General to file a Suomoto contempt of court case by any individual against Article 129 related to contempt of court. This thing we have already discussed yesterday. Once again, it was there in the newspaper. So, in terms of prelims and mains, we can expect a question related to Article 129 and Article 142, which is related to contempt of court. And the last article is related to science and tech, which talks about brain damage are after birth. This particular article starts with an small anecdote. Anecdote in the sense, the common practice. Usually, in most part of the Indian territory, when the baby has given birth, within a year, we will be perching the ears of the baby. The reason is to desperate a puff of air which is having a lack of oxygen to the brain of the particular baby till it attains the age of one. That is the scientific reason for it. There's a wide range of neurological damage which is happening in this particular case. To overcome this, They had a science and technology department with the help of lot many scientists and doctors. They formed a team, and the team was headed by Professor C.N. Kamalaratnam. He is a chief of Institute of Child Health and Hospital for Children in Chennai. His team identified and designed a new blood cell to identify if the newborn baby deprived of oxygen at birth is at risk of developing neurological disabilities later, which is being affected and having troubles in learning and hearing capability of the baby at early stages, and that also leads to reduce the intelligent quotient IQ and even develop cerebral paralysis at early ages. And they had invented two genes, that is RGS1 and SMC4, which are most significant for creating this kind of damages at early ages. And by identifying babies that are having different gene types soon after the birth, our health department can track down and those who will have adverse outcome and need specific care can be provided by the doctors at early age itself. Apart from that, in India, after prematurity and infection, a lack of oxygen to brain is the major cause of neonatal mortality or death within 28 days of the birth. That can be treated by some particular treatment, which is also given in the last paragraph of this article. Newborn baby's temperature is usually 36.5 to 37.5 degrees Celsius. But if the baby is being wrapped by a blanket and if we are reducing the temperature to 33.5 degrees Celsius for continuously 72 hours, gradually rewarming the baby by artificial means can lead to decrease or to reduce the mortality and neurological damage due to lack of oxygen supply in the body of the baby at this particular moment. This is the important innovation that we can able to get expert question with respect to body temperature of the baby that is there at the time of birth and how it can be treated. This particular gene RGS1 and SMC4 can be asked in preliminary. And now we came to an end of this today's discussion. Thank you.